हेलो एवरीवन, वेलकम टू टेस्का टेक्नोलॉजीज प्राइवेट लिमिटेड। माय नेम इज आशिम दत्ता एंड टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट डिजिटल लॉजिक ट्रेनर एंड इट्स ऑर्डर कोड इज 33511। सो इन दिस वीडियो वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट इट्स वर्किंग। नाउ लेट्स सी द कंपोनेंट्स दैट आर प्रेजेंट ऑन द किट। सो दिस इज द डीसी पावर सप्लाई ऑफ 18 वोल्ट विच वी कैन वेरी फ्रॉम 0 to +18। देन दिस इज द डीसी पावर सप्लाई ऑफ नेगेटिव 18 volt which we can vary from 0 to -18. Then this is the DC power supply of +5 volt. Here we are having +5 volt port and a ground port. This is the fixed DC power supply. Then this is the frequency generator. Here we can generate frequency of 1 hertz, then 100 hertz, then 10 kilohertz, and we can use these ports to find or course the waveform. Then this is the main power on off button. These are the 4 7-segment displays. Then this is the breadboard. This is the digital voltmeter which can read voltage from 0 to 20 volt. Then these are the output indicators. We are having 1 to 16 output indicators. And when LED is off, that means the output is low, that is 0. And when the LED is on, that means the output is high, or we can say the output is 1. Then these are the input switches from 1 to 16, and we can use these switches to give logic 1 and 0. Now we are going to perform an experiment on the kit. So the experiment we are going to perform is to see the working of NAND gate. So for that we are using a IC7400. So I have placed the IC on the breadboard, and now we will do the connections. So firstly, we will connect the 14 pin of this IC to the +5 volt supply. So I have connected the 14 pin of this IC to the +5 volt DC supply. And now we will connect the 7th pin of the IC to the ground port, like this. And now we will connect the first pin of the IC, which is the input A. So we will connect it with input first, like this. And now we will connect the second pin of the IC, that is the second input B. So we will connect it with the second input. And the third pin of the IC, that is the output pin, we will connect it with the output LED port, like this. So that is how the connection is done. Now we will switch on the kit. So after switching on the kit, we can see the output. So we will verify the NAND gate truth table. So the truth table is mentioned in the manual. So here you can see that these are the inputs A and B, and this is the output Y. So here we are having input at first and second pin of the IC, and we are having the output at third pin of the IC, and at seventh pin of the IC we are providing the ground, and at 14th pin of the IC we are providing +5 volt DC supply from here. So now currently our switch are at zero position. So we are providing zero logic at both the inputs. So at A and B we are providing 0 0, as the switch positions are at zero and the LEDs are not glowing. So that means that we are providing low input, that is the zero input. So at 0 0 0 we are getting output 1, as the output LED is glowing. So here, as you can see in the truth table, when 0 0 input is provided, the output is 1. Now when we provide input at B, we can see that when we provide input at B we are getting 1. So here we are getting 1 at the output, and now the B LED is glowing. So that means at B we are providing 1 logic. Now we will provide 1 at A and B will be 0. So at output we are still getting 1. So you can verify it on the truth table like this. Now when both A and B are 1, we are getting 0 at output. So when we give 1 at both A and B, we are getting 0 at output, as this LED is not glowing. So that means at output we are getting low output, that is the 0 output. So that is how you can verify this truth table, and you can perform other gates also. Now we are going to perform another experiment, that is to study flip-flop. So for that we can use 7470 IC or 74109 IC. So now we have to do the connections first. So firstly we will connect the first pin of the IC, that is the input R. We will connect it with any of the input switch. Then we will connect the second pin of the IC, that is the J input. So we will connect it with any of the input. Then the third pin of the IC is the K input. So we will connect it with input 5 switch. Then we will connect the fifth pin of the IC. To any of the input. So at fifth pin we are getting S input. And now we will connect the 6th pin of the IC, that is the output pin Q. And now we will connect the 7th pin of the IC, that is the Q bar output. We will connect it with any of the output LED. And now we will connect the 8th pin of the IC, that is the ground. So we will connect it with the ground port. And we will connect the 16 pin of the IC to the plus 5 volt DC supply, like this. So that is how the connection is done. Now we will switch on the kit and we will verify the truth table that is mentioned in the manual. So this is the truth table which is mentioned in the manual. So these are the inputs S, R, J, K bar, and these are the outputs Q and Q bar. So here we are having input S, then this is the R input, then this is the J input, and this is the K bar input, and this is the Q output, and this is the Q bar output. So now we will verify this truth table according to our circuit. So at first we have to give S as low and R as high and J and K at low. So we will give R as high. So now the output will be, at Q we will get high output and at Q bar we will get low output. So here you can see that this is the Q and this is the Q bar. So at Q we are getting high output, that is the one logic, and at Q bar we are getting low output, that is the logic 0, that is mentioned in the manual also. Now we will perform the second input, that is the high low. So at S we have to give high and at R we have to give low. So now we will give S high and we will give R low. So the output will be, at Q we will get L. So here you can see that at output we are getting low at Q and high at Q bar. So here also you can see that at Q we are getting low and at Q bar we are getting high input, that is the one logic. So now we will provide S and R both low and we will get high at Q and Q bar. So when we provide low at S and R and J and K, then we are getting high at Q and high at Q bar also. So similarly you can verify all these inputs and you can get the outputs on the output LEDs. So that is how you can verify this truth table. You can use any of the output LEDs, like if you want to use the second LED, you can use that LED also. If you want to use other LED, you can use that LED also. Similarly with the input pins also, you can use any of the input pins like this. So that is how we can use any of the input from 1 to 16, and we can use any of the output, that is 1 to 16 LEDs. So these glowing of the LED means that we are getting high input, that is the logic 1, and the dimness of or not glowing the LED indicates that we are getting low output, that is the logic 0. So when the LED is off, we are getting 0 logic. So that is how you can perform this experiment, and you can perform other flip-flops also. We can also measure the variable voltage. So for that, we will connect firstly the positive 18 volt variable voltage to the digital voltmeter. So we will connect the positive with the positive and the negative with the ground, like this. And now we will switch on the kit, and here you can see that it is reading approx 18 volt when the port is at fully clockwise direction, but when we rotate it in anti-clockwise direction, we can vary the voltage. So here you can see that we can vary the voltage, as it is now 10 volt approximately. We can reduce it to 1 volt also. So by using this port, we can vary the voltage. Similarly, we can do it for the negative one also. So for that, we will connect the negative with the ground and the positive with the positive. And now we will switch on the kit. So here you can see that this negative sign indicates that we are using this negative DC power supply. So we can vary it. So when you rotate it in clockwise direction, the voltage is shown as, right now it is approximately 17 volt. And when you rotate it in anti-clockwise direction, it shows minus 4 volt approximately. So that is how you can use both of these variable DC power supplies. We can also see the working of the 7 segment display also. So for that, firstly we will connect the input 1 with the D port of one of the 7 segment display, and we will connect the second input to the C port of the 7 segment display. Then we will connect the third input port with the B port, and we will connect the A port of the 7 segment display to the fourth input pin, like this. And now we will switch on the kit. So when the switch is at 0 logic position, so the 7 segment is showing 0. Now we will provide 1, then we will provide 2, then we will provide 3, then we will provide 4, then 5, then we will provide 6, then 7, then 8, and then 9. So we can read up to 9 by using this 7 segment display. Similarly, we can do this for the 3 7 segment display also by using these input pins. So that is how we can perform this also. So that's all the demonstration from my side. If you have any query related to this kit, you can contact at Tesca Global website. You can find the link in the description. For more information, go through the manual. Thank you for watching this video. If you like this video, like, share and subscribe to our channel.